A little bit closer. Yeah, like this.
Like this?
Yeah. So we're gonna continue. And for this part of the symposium, we have artist Mutaz Al-Bashar from Syria, and Josh Karam, his interpreter. And Mutaz will talk a little bit about having a reflection on the situation of art and museums in Syria. So there will be more or less a 20-minute presentation, and then you guys are going to open up for questions.
Yep.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
مساء الخير.
Good evening, everyone.
حابب أعرف إذا في حدا بيحكي عربي.
I would like to know if someone of the audience maybe speaks Arabic. A little bit.
على كل حال صار الدنيا ما سمعت في مجال تعلمه اليوم.
Anyhow, it's a bit late today, so you don't have time to learn Arabic today, so we'll keep it in English.
أنا راح أحكي عن سوريا. بس ليش صار فيها هيك؟ مين هي سوريا يعني؟
I will speak a bit about Syria and why the catastrophe or what is happening today.
بهذا المكان من العالم كان للإنسان تجربته العميقة.
In this place of the world, the human or the man had a deep and wide experience.
هناك في سوريا تصارعت القوى العظمى ليس في العصر الحديث فحسب
there,
بس في العصر القديم ايضا
there in Syria the greatest empires have fought not only like the modern forces but also the ancient forces as well or the empires
فهناك تصارع الروم والفرس والعرب المسلمين على نفس الارض
There on the very same territory, the Muslim Arabs, the Persians, and the Romans fought.
لماذا كانت سوريا هي محور هذه الأحداث؟
Why was Syria the actual location of these events?
سأستعرض معكم قليلاً من التاريخ السوري.
I will go through the history of Syria a little bit with you.
في سوريا. أقدم أبجدية في التاريخ.
In Syria, there is the oldest alphabet.
وكان ذلك عام 1500 قبل الميلاد.
Dating back to 1500 before Christ.
في أوغاريت الواقع على الساحل السوري في مدينة رأس شمرة.
In Ugarit, located on the Syrian coast at Ras Shamra.
وعلى الأرض السورية.
And on the Syrian territory.
اكتشف أقدم مشهد لفرقة موسيقية.
The oldest scene of a group orchestra has been discovered.
وكان ذلك عام 1400 قبل الميلاد.
And that was 1400 before Christ.
وهي عبارة عن أربع أبيات مكتوبة في اللغة الحورية.
And it contains four verses written in the nymph language.
موجهة لآلهة القمر نيكال لزوجة إله القمر نيكال
and commanded to the goddess Nikal the wife of the moon of the god of moon
في سوريا أقدم معاهدة سلام في التاريخ
in Syria there is the oldest peace or peace treaty in the world or the world have ever witnessed
في منطقة النبي مندو
in the territory or in the area of Prophet Mandi.
وكانت هذه المعاهدة بين المتصارعين بين العرب بين الحثيين والفراعنة.
And this treaty or the Kurdish treaty was concluded between the emperor of the Hittites and the emperor and the pharaohs.
عام 1296 قبل الميلاد.
Dating back to 1296 before Christ.
وكان فيها مكر سياسي وكان فيها دبلوماسية وكان فيها مباركة دينية.
Which included legal, military, and diplomatic clauses that fixed the relations between the two parties.
أول حقل قمح في التاريخ زرع في سوريا في 6700 قبل الميلاد.
The first wheat field or the first field of wheat was planted or grew in Syria 6,700 years before Christ.
وأول من صنع الخبز.
As well as the bread industry.
ماذا تقولون بمن يقدم لهذا العالم الأبجدية والخبز؟
And what do you say to those people who provide to the world the alphabet and the bread?
هذا الصراع لم يكن عسكريا فحسب وسياسيا أيضا.
Besides all the military, politically and ideologically struggles.
في سوريا قناة مائية بطول 150 كيلومتر.
There in Syria there is a water channel for 150 kilometers.
قدمها أمير السلمية.
Which was given by the prince of the Samian city.
سلمية مدينة مدينة السلمية.
The city is called Salamiya, so which was given by the prince of this city.
لخطيبته أميرة أفاميا وجر لها المياه 150 كيلومتر.
That was given as a present or a gift to his fiance, which is the princess of Afamia, and so he drew the water all the way from his kingdom to her kingdom, which is 150 kilometers.
وعرفت هذه القناة بقناة العاشق.
And this channel was known throughout history as the lover's channel.
وهناك عاشق آخر.
And there is another lover.
كان هو السبب الرئيسي بسقوط دمشق أمام العرب المسلمين.
Which is the major reason, or which was the major cause for Damascus to fall in front of the Muslim Arabs.
واسمه يونان.
And his name was Yunan.
والسبب كان أن الرومان رفضوا تزويجه لرومية فأسقط الروم جميعا في الشام.
And the reason was that the Romans refused or rejected his marriage proposal to his love or to his fiance. So he dropped the whole city on their heads, so to say.
هكذا هو الحب في بلادنا.
So is love in his country.
لأن سوريا كانت في هذا المكان من العالم.
Because Syria has been and still the center.
والمتحف السوري الحقيقي ليس في أبنية المتاحف.
And the real Syrian museum is not like the rest of the
museums
and doesn't even, yeah.
بل إن الأرض السورية أينما ذهبت تجد الأقواس والأعمدة والفخاريات والمخطوطات في كل مكان من الأرض السورية.
However, the whole Syrian territory is a museum, because you can find arcs, markets, columns, walls, castles, forts, wherever you go in Syria.
وما هو في باطن الأرض أكثر بكثير مما هو في ظاهرها.
And what is in the ground is more, much more than what is on its surface, in the earth ground though, so to say.
هناك مدرج بصرة وقلعة الحصن وقلعة المرقب.
There we have the amphitheater, Busra, and the citadel of Al-Husn and citadel Al-Marqab.
وقلعة المرقب.
المرقب. Citadel Al-Marqab. Yeah.
وقلعة صلاح الدين وغيرها الكثير.
And citadel of Salah al-Din and much more.
يقول عالم الآثار أندرو باولو.
The French archaeologist
Andrew Barrow. لكل إنسان متحضر في هذا العالم وطنان.
The French archaeologist Andrew Barrow says that for every civilized person on this in this world,
وطنه الذي يعيش فيه هو سوريا.
For every civilized human being in this world, two nations: his native country and Syria.
لكل هذه الأسباب.
For all these reasons.
ومنها الكثير.
And a lot of it.
التي لا يستطيع الوقت لذكرها.
Which I cannot mention it because of time.
كان المشهد السوري المشهد الفني حاضرا في التاريخ السوري.
A lot of them that I don't have time to talk about, art of all its kinds was present in the Syrian scenes through its history.
في كل العصور في كل الأزمنة كان يرافق المشهد الفن.
As I said before, the art of all its kind was present in the Syrian scene in its ancient, medieval, and contemporary history.
المتخصصين بالفن السوري يعرفون أن هناك ظاهرة رافقت هذا الفن.
People who are specialized in the Syrian art knows that there is a phenomenon in this art.
وهي بالرغم من الأكاديميات والمعاهد والمدارس التي تعنى بتدريس الفن.
Which is despite the existence of academies, technical institutes, and schools specialized in art.
إلا أن غالبية الفنانين السوريين
yeah.
كانوا يأتون من مكان آخر.
Whereas the majority of the Syrian artists came from other places.
وهي الأماكن الأكثر فطرية والتي تعيش الحياة البدائية.
Which are the places that are the most wild places and that was living the ancient life or the
بعيدا عن الأكاديميات والمدارس الفنية.
Far from the academies and the technical institutes.
ومن هؤلاء الفنانين من كان له حظ أن يكون بالأسماء العالمية.
And some of these artists had the luck to be on the international ground or of artists, like their names were shown or and their names were heard internationally.
لكل هذه الأسباب كان لابد أن يكون في سوريا متاحف.
For all these reasons that I mentioned before, you can conclude that we should have had and we should have museums in Syria to store.
وبالفعل في سوريا بكل مدينة يوجد متحف صغير أو كبير.
To store all the fabulous wealth of the Syrian archaeology and art. And indeed, in every and each city in Syria, you can actually find a museum, either a large or a small museum.
سأتكلم عن متحفين.
I'm going to talk about two of them.
متحف دمشق الوطني.
The most important museum is Damascus National Museum.
ومتحف حلب.
And the Museum of Aleppo.
متحف دمشق واللي هو موجود تحت سيطرة النظام.
The Museum of Damascus and which is controlled by the Syrian regime today.
وهو يحتوي على الكثير الكثير من آثار الجنوب والوسط السوري.
Which contains a lot and thousands of artifacts and manuscripts of from the south and from the center of Syria.
من المخطوطات والأوابد والنسخة الأصلية للأبجدية السورية.
With artifacts, manuscripts, and even the original copy of the alphabet, of the Syrian alphabet.
وهناك متحف حلب وحلب موجودة بالشمال السوري.
And there is also the Museum of Aleppo, and Aleppo is located on the northern part of Syria, شمال.
والذي يعرف تاريخ السوري.
And for those who know the Syrian history,
يعرف أنه يتركز في الشمال.
Knows that its history is based and centered in the north of Syria.
وهذا المتحف يلخص تاريخ الشمال.
And this museum summarizes the history of North Syria.
والمتحفين هما عبارة عن ثروة طائلة من الآثار.
And both museums are actually an example of this fabulous wealth.
وأنتم تعرفون أن الأثر مثل الإنسان إذا مات لا يعود.
And you actually knows that, I think you guys are already aware that archaeologists are like people. When dead, they never come back.
هذين المتحفين لا يزالان في حالة آمنة.
And I can say that both museums are today in good conditions.
ولكن هذا الأمان بظل الظروف العسكرية فهو غير مستقر.
But this safe condition that I'm talking about, taking into consideration all the military conflicts and changes on the ground, is not stable actually. And it's difficult to predict.
وصعب جدا التنبؤ بالمستقبل.
It's really, really difficult to predict in the future.
هناك قصة مستقلة في سوريا وهي تدمر بالميرا.
There is another independent story in Syria which is called Palmyra.
هذه المدينة هي متحف في الهواء الطلق.
This city is a museum by itself.
فيها الأبراج وهي القبور التدمرية.
It contains huge towers which are basically the Palmyrian tombs.
فيها مسرح كبير يتوسط المدينة.
There is also a big theater in the center of the city.
وقوس النصر والشارع المستقيم.
And the Arc of Victory and the شارع المستقيم
and
the straight road.
ومعبد بل الضخم.
And the temple of Bel.
ومعبد بعل شامين.
And the temple of Baal Shamin.
وهذه الآثار جميعها موجودة في قلب البادية السورية.
And all these monuments and archaeologies are located in the heart of the Syrian desert.
تعرضت بالميرا إلى سيطرة الدولة النظام تنظيم الدولة وتارة إلى سيطرة النظام.
Palmyra has actually been controlled by both parties. First, it was controlled by ISIS, and then was controlled by the Syrian regime.
ومع ذلك برأي كثير من المتخصصين أن بالميرا في وضع جيد.
And even though it has been controlled by both parties that are in war, according to a lot of specialists and knowledgeable people, Palmyra is still in good condition today.
بالرغم من تهدم جزء من معبد بيل.
We should not underestimate the destruction of a significant part of Bel temple.
وكأن التاريخ لا يريد أن يغادر المكان.
As if history does not want to leave this place.
انتهت المحنة طبعا بعد مأساة إنسانية كبيرة جدا.
The Palmyrian tribulation has actually ended, but after a very big tragedy that affected the human dramatically.
ولكن الآن بسوريا نستطيع أن نقول أن عمل المتاحف متوقف بشكل كبير.
Nowadays, I can easily say that the work of museums is more or less paralyzed in Syria. It's totally stopped.
إلا في حالات استثنائية.
Except for some exceptional cases.
ولكن أريد أن أتحدث عن أمر مهم قد يكون أهم من المتاحف.
But I want to address another subject that is very important to me and actually much more important than the museums itself themselves.
وهم الفنانين السوريين الذين يأتون من نتاج طبيعي للأرض السورية.
And this issue is actually the Syrian artist himself that are produced and that come from the heart of the Swedish territory, of the Syrian territories.
هؤلاء الفنانين قد خسروا أماكنهم ومراسمهم والطقس الفني الذي كانوا يعيشون وينعمون به.
These artists have actually lost the right atmosphere to practice their artistic work.
سوريا كانت أجواء مناسبة جدا للفن.
Syria had a really, really, really attractive and distinctive, appropriate atmosphere, or what we call artistic atmosphere.
ولم تكن فقط للفنانين السوريين، فهناك كثير من فنانين العالم والعرب كانوا لهم مراسم في سوريا، يأتون فقط لممارسة الفن.
Syria was never the home of the serious artist of the Syrian artist only. Rather, it warmly welcomed the Arabs and the international artists as well.
بحثاً عن الأجواء المناسبة لممارسة الفن.
And suddenly, and without a prior warning, the Syrian artist started seeking safety everywhere in the world. Except in his native home, Syria.
وبدون سابق انذار.
And a large of Syrian artists migrated to different countries of the world, which puts the artist's identity in danger.
أصبح الفنان السوري يبحث عن الأمان في كل العالم.
Which made the Syrian artist seeking peace again in the rest of the world.
ما عدا وطنه الأصلي سوريا.
Except of his native home, Syria.
فخرج عدد كبير من الفنانين.
So a lot of Syrian artists left the country.
وأنتم تعرفون أن الفنانين غير ميالين لحمل السلاح.
عفوا.
أنتم تعرفون أن الفنانين غير ميالين لا يحبون حمل السلاح.
And you, as you actually know, that artists are against holding carrying weapons and fighting.
ولذلك إن الهوية السورية الفنية.
And therefore, the Syrian artistic identity.
تتعرض الآن لخطر كبير.
Is in the danger zone today.
وذوبان الخصوصية والدهشة.
And which make it lose it or for it being in the danger zone, like of assimilation and loss of the exclusiveness and of the exclusive ideas they had.
كما أن كثير من الفنانين دفع ثمن كبير لأنه انحاز لأحد الأطراف الصراع.
Also, many of these artists has actually paid the cost for them for their political views, which was biased to one party or to another, which put them.
وأنا الآن هنا بينكم في هذا البلد الجميل الآمن.
Which put them and their work in danger. And now I'm standing here in front of you in this beautiful and secure country.
لقد شدني فعلا عالم المتاحف بالسويد.
I'm one of these artists and I've been really attracted to the world of museums in Sweden.
وزرت الكثير منها وخاصة متحف الفن الحديث، متاحف الفن الحديث.
And I visited a lot of them, especially the modern art museums.
وأعتقد أننا كفنانين سوريين نستطيع أن نكون جزء من هذه المنظومة أو من هذا المكان.
And I think that we as Syrian artists can be a part of this work or project or program that is ongoing.
ومن خلال تجربتي البسيطة في السويد.
And through my simple and humble experience in Sweden.
عرفت أن هناك رعاية فنية وكذلك يوجد في السويد ذائقة فنية متطورة تضمن للفنان استمراريته.
Through my simple experience and humble experience in Sweden, I knew that there is a good care, or they take really good care of artists here. And most importantly, the art is an urgent need for the Swedish taster.
وفي الختام,
and in the end,
أستطيع أن أقول لكم أن ما يجري في سوريا هو ظاهرة طبيعية.
This is really important. In the end, I can tell you that what is happening in Syria today is a very normal phenomenon in history.
لأن الأمم العظيمة هي التي تتعرض إلى أزمات عظيمة.
Because the great nations are those who get exposed to the great crisis.
ولكن المزعج هي التفاصيل.
But details are always annoying.
شكرا.
Thank you.
Thanks. Oh. I think we have time for two quick questions. Geraldine? A microphone is coming.
I have a question regarding Palmyra and all the sites you mentioned. Because now it's very... Oh, I can put it here.
Yeah. You're good now.
Yeah, cool.
Not anymore.
So, about this, I guess, trend of digitizing archaeological sites and, you know, digitizing Palmyra, for instance, so they can have a 3D object, and then, you know, once you have it digitized, it equals to taking care of it, and then they 3D print it and put it in London, which is like...
Palmyra.
Yeah, and I don't know, like, if he knows something about, like, if there is any value for...
Any?
Value. If it has any value for...
Value?
Value for the Syrian community, like museum community or artistic community, these digitalization processes of, you know, historical sites, if he is familiar with that.
عم تقول انه بتدمر اخذوها مثلا وطلعوا صور واخذوهم على المتاحف بلندن وحطوهم هناك، هل انه
هيدا الشيء يعني انت can you just tell me the question in the end because I explained what you said briefly but I just want the
community of museums and artists and people there like in Syria it has any value or it means for them it represents any importance at all the fact that Western you know museums and Google are digitizing these sites as a way to taking care of heritage while not taking care of the artists, of course, or something like.
هي عم بتقول إنه هن الغرب أخذوا هيدا الأمور وحطوها مثلاً طلعوا على صور وأخذوها على المتاحف اللي عندهم وعم بعلموها على أساس إنه هن عم بيحموا هيدا الأثار وهيدا المتاحف. هل شو رأي الشعب يعني شو رأي العالم أو أنت رأيك شخصي بأنه تتاخذ هيدا الأمور لبرا وتتعلم غير إنه تنحمى محل ما هي؟
لا نحن ما 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 في ثقة بهالنقطة هاي يعني عند الناس السوريين ما في ثقة بهالنقطة هاي لأنه اللي ما بيقدر يحمي الإنسان ما راح يقدر يحمي الآثار
لا لا يلي ما بيوثق بإنسان
اللي ما بيحمي الإنسان ما بيقدر يحمي الآثار
As Syrian people and the Syrian community we do not trust that they are protecting or taking care of their of these art works of art crafts because someone who cannot protect people cannot protect arts and archaeologies.
Camilla? You have a question?
I'm going to reflect on your question, if I understood it right. But if not Syria can take care of or digitize their own cultural heritage, what can the museums outside Syria do? Also for maintaining free speech for artists and keep on working with the art practice. Is there something that we could? I think it's a question of solidarity, of course. So what can other museums do to help Syria or to help the community in this crisis?
What can other communities do in order to help Syria in this crisis and the Syrian community?
What other museums can do? To help the issues that is in front of us in Syria.
شو دور المتاحف بغير دول وشو دور غير دول اليوم لأنها تحمي
شو إيش
شو دور
دور المتاحف
المتاحف البقوة بالعالم وشو دور الدول البقوة بأنها تحمي هيدي المتاحف بسوريا وتحمي الحضارة والثقافة اللي عم نخسرها اليوم أمام هيدي الاضطرابات اللي عم بتصير اليوم.
يعني هن المفروض يبحثوا عن دور لإلهم لأنه سوريا حاليا صارت مكان غير محمي.
They should find a role for themselves to do because Syria today is not protected at all. So I don't know what their role is but they should find something to do. More or less.
I have a final but perhaps quick question. I don't know, depends on the answer. Based on this history of the thing that you told us about, let's say this harmonious community of different artists coming elsewhere and living together and in a really prospect way.
Wait a second. انطلاعا من التاريخ اللي خبرتنا عنه وانه انت قلت انه سوريا مش كانت بس وطن لبس للفنانين السوريين كانت وطن لكل الفنانين اللي بيجوا من غير دول كعربية او من دول عالمية.
Yes, and now you find yourself here in Sweden for the last 3 years.
وهلا انت بالسويد من 3 سنين لورا يعني هلا انت
شلون
وانت اليوم بالسويد صار لك 3 سنين.
And perhaps you talk about how artists could be welcomed, and let's say the people here don't know how to do that, how to somehow integrate, because perhaps they don't have knowledge or different cultures. Actually being allowed their different knowledge and epistemologies or ways of living. Let me put again, how could you propose, based on this history that you talked about, Syria as a really striving arts community, ways of integrating to actually welcome artists from elsewhere?
انطلاعا من التاريخ اللي انت حكيت عنه عن تاريخ سوريا وسوريا هي ما بت يعني مش بس وطن للفنان السوري انما وطن للفنان العالمي. في عندك أي اقتراح أو أي طريقة أو أي ملاحظة حتى رأي بأنه نحن كيف فينا نخلق طرق لحتى نقول أهلا وسهلا للفنان اللي جاي من غير ثقافة وللفنان اللي جاي من غير دولتنا هون ونقدر نختلط مع بعض ونقدر نشتغل سوا؟
يعني أنا برأيي أنا مثلاً إذا بدي أحكي لك عن تجربتي فما توقفت ولا يوم بهدول الثلاث سنين وفي كثير مثلي ما رح يقدروا يوقفوا. الفنانين السوريين نتاج طبيعي ما هم مصنعين بالأكاديميات فإنه يوقفوا هذا مسألة كتير صعبة.
بس انت عندك شي طرق
الاقتراح
تنصحهم لحتى انه هن كيف يقولوا اهلا وسهلا للفنان اللي جاي من برا؟
يعني الاقتراح انه يعملوا لهم ورشات عمل.
سوري. During my 3 years here in Sweden I never stopped a day. I've been producing since day one I entered this country and I've been doing new paints since I lost my work that I've done before. So my proposal would be is to create programs or projects for the artists coming from other cultures in order to have a role or in order to show their art here, like create programs and projects for them to be involved in.
That would be great. Let's finish that perhaps. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.